guys, happy Vlogmas day 4. Woohoo! I'm just sipping on a little chocolate matcha from the Matcha Reserve, sweetened with a few drops of the chocolate sweet leaf stevia drops that I get from iHerb or Vitacost in my Totoro mug here. Really enjoying that. I'm kind of excited because the folks at Matcha Reserve sent me some plain matcha as well, and I'm gonna try it in a few days here with some beauty dust in it to see how the flavors meld. So that will be exciting. But today I am gonna be reviewing for you guys the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Hydrating 100% Hydrogel Mask with Hyaluronic Acid in it. I saw this and picked it up in Walmart when I went in there the other day with you guys a while back, and have been wanting to try it out. You saw me do it just now, and that is the probably third time that I've done this mask so that I could form a good review of it for you guys. So first up, just as far as the mask itself, this is a hydrogel mask. Hydrogel is a material that is frequently used in wound dressings. It's semi-permeable, and so it kind of allows the wound, if you will, to get adequate oxygen, but is also protected from pathogens and things in the environment so that the wound can properly heal. It also keeps the wound bed, you know, nicely hydrated so that the new healthy skin tissue can come in with the immune system into the wound and help heal the skin from a wound, okay? And the nice thing about hydrogels is that they can be impregnated with a variety of compounds, so they can serve as a nice delivery device as well. And that's what Neutrogena has capitalized on here in making and crafting this hydrogel mask. A variety of other masks use hydrogel as well. The Tony Moly eye masks that I reviewed a while back have them. But here's what it looks like. I just saved this one here. You know, you can see it's almost like a jelly-like mesh here. And so you should know that before you go cracking into this thing, because it is pretty slippery. I think Neutrogena screwed up a little bit and caused a problem for consumers, myself included, as you probably saw. So this mask is designed to go on the face and sit on there for 15 minutes. It comes with a white backing that you're supposed to peel off. The problem is that white backing slides right off as you're pulling the mask out, and the top half and the mask is in two pieces. There's a top half and a bottom half. It's really quite smart, actually, the shape of the mask. But those two pieces separate, and so, you know, they'll fall on your lap, they'll fall on the floor if you just pull it out, which the packaging, that's really the only way to get it out. Really what they should have done was put a mask like this in a tray where you take off the top and then you just lift up the pieces and put them on your face and not mess with this white backing. It's pretty hardy. It's pretty resilient. It doesn't tear when taking out of the packaging. I think that was a complaint consumers had with previous renditions of the Neutrogena sheet masks. This particular hydrogel polymer that they have crafted in this mask is pretty sturdy, okay? You can see here, this is just the residua of it. Overall, the mask feels pretty nice going on, and like I said, it's intended to be left on the face for anywhere from 15 to 30 minutes, okay? Ingredient-wise, let's go over what ingredients this mask has in it. You know, I'll try and give you kind of the objective rundown here. Let me just get a little sip of the chocolate antioxidant. To be honest, Neutrogena really didn't put much in the mask itself that is an actual moisturizer. I was surprised to see they didn't put glycerin, for example. They kind of just stuck to castor oil as a moisturizer, and then they put hyaluronic acid in the mask. Hyaluronic acid is a humectant. It holds on to water, okay? So you put this mask on a wet face, and those little hyaluronic acid molecules will kind of sponge up some of the water and keep it stuck on your face for a time. And the idea of doing it under occlusion is that you drive those water molecules, you know, hopefully into deeper layers of your skin so that the skin plumps up and stays hydrated and the skin barrier stays nice and healthy, okay? So they have hyaluronic acid, but on its own, hyaluronic acid isn't necessarily super moisturizing. It just kind of gloms onto water. It's sort of like a sponge. So, you know, they have that in there. And then they have a two interesting ingredients. One is Tremella fusiformis, which is the snow mushroom. Snow mushroom is something that's like been popular in Chinese traditional medicine for eons. It's consumed in the diet. A variety of dishes have this edible mushroom in them. If you've ever cooked with mushrooms, you know this isn't rocket science. Mushrooms absorb a lot of water. And this particular mushroom, Tremella fusiformis, or the snow mushroom, really does. I think, you know, if you Google or YouTube snow mushroom, somebody puts it in some water and it just blooms into this massive thing. So, you know, cosmetic companies are all over this because it's like a new, something they can call, you know, an all-natural humectant. And it's less scary sounding to consumers to put a chopped up mushroom on their face than, you know, chopped up synthetic hyaluronic acid molecules on their face. But at the end of the day, these little molecules, whether they be plant derived or man-made, they're all intended just to kind of sponge onto water and hold it on there on your face. Hyaluronic acid in and of itself, you know, synthetic hyaluronic acid is not irritating or harmful, but I can see them wanting to amp it up with something natural just to kind of appeal to consumer desires. The mushroom itself, the humectant properties within the mushroom derive from, it's rich in polysaccharides, things that, you know, have these long tails that kind of hold on to water, kind of like Swiffer sweepers. And so really what's interesting though is that the little molecules are actually somewhat smaller than hyaluronic acid. So theoretically, you know, they can hold on to water and bring it into the skin a little bit slightly deeper, theoretically. But there's really no evidence that putting this mushroom in skincare products is necessarily safe and or effective, okay? So, you know, I always tell you guys, like, just because something is natural doesn't necessarily mean that it's useful or safe, okay? And mushrooms, I think, you know, again, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to know that many mushrooms are magical and not necessarily intended for human health, if you know what I mean. It can be very dangerous. But, you know, this one's been consumed by the Chinese people for many, 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 many years. So I'm assuming that the edible mushroom itself is safe. So there's that. Laboratory studies, okay, we're talking cells on a dish, incredibly different from human skin, all right? Everybody gets excited when they see a study, you know, on human tissue in a dish or something like that, or human skin cells in a dish. It's simply not the same thing, okay? I mean, there you've just taken the cells out and they're just kind of laying there. It's not a functional organ like your skin, whose main function it is to keep things out, okay? So I am less like wowed by laboratory studies of ingredients. I mean, I like it. I think it's exciting to see scientific data, but I don't start applying that to, I don't think that's applicable to people until I see bigger studies in people, which this mushroom is simply lacking, okay? But the lab studies on cells in a dish show that, you know, these extracts have free radical scavenging, you know, properties, that they are moisture retaining, more so than hyaluronic acid in some studies. So seems to be a promising ingredient as far as a cosmetic ingredient, something that would be desirable. And so a lot of companies are putting it into their products. Neutrogena is not unique in that. Seems to be well tolerated, no reports of allergic contact dermatitis to the mushroom, so seems to be safe. Then the other ingredient in this is Plucinicia volubilis, which is the Sacha Incha, hard to say. Sacha Incha, you may have seen that, you know, name or that promoted in like foods and, you know, these superfoods and superfood smoothies. A lot of like, you know, diet and holistic health people are all over this. This is a vine from the Amazonian rainforest, my favorite place. No, that's not two-day delivery, but it's rich in omega-3 oils, okay? Like linoleic oils and fatty acids. And those oils have been shown in some small studies in people to be kind of helpful in restoring the skin barrier, but don't get super excited about it. Those particular omega fatty oils, they're, you know, not really any better than any plain moisturizer necessarily. So people, you know, always want my opinion on oils and which oils to use. Honestly, just stick to a basic moisturizer. moisturizer. Oils on their own aren't fantastic moisturizing ingredients. They're just too slippery. When they're added to basic moisturizers, they usually perform pretty well. And so that's how I would select them. But I wouldn't like lose sleep over trying to find one that's, you know, rich in omega-3 or linoleic acid or something like that, because it's just not super impressive that those are necessary, or, you know, really that strong of a skin hydrator or skin barrier repairer. All right, so those are kind of the ingredients. The number one problematic ingredient, and where I really just want to, you know, slap Neutrogena on the wrist, and I'm really disappointed in them, is that they went ahead and put fragrance in this. And as you guys know, fragrance in cosmetics and skincare is really a major problem. Like, I say it on here over and over again, and will continue to say it. It is by far and away one of the most offensive things in skincare, and is largely responsible for most things that, quote, break you out or irritate your skin. A lot of times it has to do with people developing a sensitivity to fragrance, because it's really, really in many, many, many skincare products, okay, including this one. And the fragrance is pretty strong. When you put it on and you're wearing the mask, you don't actually notice the fragrance, maybe because, you know, it is semi-permeable and their fragrance molecules don't, you know, make it to your olfactory system. But that's your smelling system. You know, when you take the mask off, your face smells kind of baby powdery, and it's pretty strong and a little bit headache inducing. So I don't know why they had to go and put that in there. I mean, honestly, nobody's sheet mask needs to smell like that. But I was sort of underwhelmed by this mask. I think they've got a jazzy carrier here in terms of the dress. It's basically the dressing here is pretty cool, this material. But they neglected to put adequate moisturizers on this. It's not super moisturizing. It's not super hydrating, honestly. They put some humectants in here and not enough moisturizers, okay? So I really don't feel as though when I take this mask off, my skin is any more hydrated, any more supple. And so I think they kind of failed ingredient-wise to impregnate this with anything that's actually super moisturizing. And the humectants on here, I don't know, they didn't really sail through in terms of, I didn't feel like my skin was any plumper or anything after using this. In the medical setting, when, you know, hydrogels are used on wounds and things, they're, because they're kind of non-adherent, they generally require some sort of overlay or something to keep it in place, because you could see, you know, this morning in me showing you guys that this kind of slides around a little bit. I think you're okay to just park it on your face, but you may be better served with this mask if you use the Daiso silicone overlay mask that I have. I'll list it down below. I got it on Amazon for like change, and you can get it at, I think, Daiso for like $1. They're pretty inexpensive. Oh, and I saw Walmart has started carrying them now too, so you can get it there. But yeah, overall, I would say, you know, they should work on this a little bit more. They've got a little bit more work to do. Neutrogena has a little bit more work to do in designing a sheet mask, okay? 6 months or so ago, I took a pretty nasty spill and got a pretty deep cut on my arm here, and I used a hydrogel-like dressing like this on part of the cut, and it really felt nice as it was healing and the skin was coming together and getting dry and itchy. Overall, I think they really have some more work to do to get this to be something that is useful to consumers. It's pretty expensive. And so, you know, who do I think will capture the consumer's interest a little bit better as far as drugstore American sheet masks? I think Garnier did a little bit better job and will appeal to more people in their sheet masks, specifically the Skin Active Moisture Balm Super Hydrating Mask. I have done this a variety of times. I'm sorry I don't have the unopened package, but I actually thought it was better as far as a moisturizing sheet mask than this Neutrogena hydrogel mask. It has castor oil in it. I believe that one has glycerin. It's just a little bit more moisturizing. It also has licorice root extract, which can be brightening to the skin. Their selling ingredient in the Garnier one is their pomegranate extract, which, you know, theoretically is rich in antioxidants. Left on the face in a mask, that's kind of a, you know, a shot in the dark, okay, but doesn't seem to be harmful at this point, so that's fine. Unfortunately, Garnier also put fragrance in their mask, and it is pretty strong. The other ingredient in the Garnier Skin Balm masks is witch hazel, which you guys know I really like. It's a very soothing, gentle astringent. So I think folks who are, you know, looking for a mask that has brightening effects and or is, you know, kind of good for oily shininess, I think you would be a lot happier with the Garnier ones. They're more moisturizing and they're more affordable. I think the Garnier one is $250. So that one's a pretty good one. But you know, honestly, I have to say I reviewed some Japanese sheet masks for you guys a while back, and I've got to say, coming back to that, the Lululemon one I think is a far better deal. This one from Japan, you can get this on Amazon. It's $7 for 7 masks. Actually, it's a little over $7, depending on... Have you noticed Amazon, depending on the time of day that you buy something, the price can be any which way to sideways. But I paid $7 for this. I think I paid $7.50 for it, which isn't a bad price. So, you know, a little over a dollar per mask. This is super hydrating, has no fragrance in it, and has no really offensive ingredients. I think this is a better investment and will serve more people more generally. The blue one, they have a variety of different colors. This blue one is very, very no nonsense. So yeah, that's my review of the hydrogel mask. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Overall, you know, I was underwhelmed with it. I would not repurchase it. I hope they come out with I'm sure they will, you know, revamp it and come out with a newer rendition. Skincare companies are always, you know, changing things around and discontinuing things and, you know, trying to one-up themselves and one-up everybody else around it. In the meantime, just kind of wasting resources. But, you know, hopefully they can improve upon the both the packaging, the design, and some of the moisturizing ingredients in this. And please, Neutrogena, if you are watching this, which I doubt you are, please, please, please leave fragrance out of this, okay? I cannot recommend this strongly so long as it has fragrance in it. I did also pick up the Hydro Boost Hydrating Overnight Gel Mask. I haven't tried this one yet. It has identical ingredients to the hydrogel mask, however, aside from the fact that it's lacking the hydrogel mask, okay? So it has all the same kind of humectants in it, just in this jelly-like substance that you leave on your face. This product, I imagine, is going to be kind of an American drugstore dupe for the Belief Aqua Bomb that I tried out for you guys a while back, and you all seem to enjoy my review. So let me know if you've tried this one and what you think of it, if it's any better than that sheet mask. I look forward to trying them out, but yeah. I'm just about finished with my matcha green tea here. I'm gonna go fire up my Bustelo with Beauty Dust and head on out for my day. So I hope you guys enjoyed the review today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.